Hello, and in today's 80MHz328P programming tutorial, I am going to be doing linking LEDs and running LEDs as well. Now, for the schematic, we have the basic setup here just to get the 80MHz328P running, and then on its D port, I have 8 LEDs connected. Now, since this is an 8-bit processor, most of your ports will only be 8 bits wide, as well as any of the registers in the 80MHz328P. So for the D port, it's just connected easy because this is the only port that has all 8 pins exposed on its port. Okay, now let's have a look at the data sheet. Now in section 13 we have the IO ports, which is basically just general purpose input output, and then I have a equivalent circuit over here for the pins on the 80MHz328P. So the basics is we have our logic output. This can be run through a internal pull-up resistor on the 80MHz328P. Then the pin also has some input capacitance and the two diodes for its impedance state. Then we have all registers and bit references in this section are written in general form. A lowercase x represents the number letter for the port, and a lower n represents the bit number. For example, if you have port B3, then they are referencing this pin on the 80MHz328P. And this is common across the entire datasheet. You will typically see letter and number as the reference. What we need to concern ourselves with to generate an output, you see it has three memory addresses locations are associated with each port. The primary registers we are going to concern ourselves with is the port X register and the DDR X register. Pin X is a register we are going to use with inputs. So the only two registers we require is the port register and the DDR X register. Now in the case, since the LEDs are wired to the D port, it will be port D and DDR D as the output. Then we have ports as general input output, or IO for short. Then we just skip down to configuring a pin over here. And here they just state that they have these three registers again. We just care about the DD register and the port register. Then over here we have if the DD register is written logic 1, pin XN is configured as an output pin. Now this is different from any other microcontroller I have ever worked with. Usually output is 0 and usually input is 1. But in this case, it is flipped. Then we have if port XN is written logic 1, when the pin is configured as an output pin, the port is driven high, so logic 1. So if you write to port 1 and your pin is configured as an output, then you will output 5 volts on the pin. And then again, if you write a 0 to that port pin, then you will output a logic 0. So 0 volts, it will go to ground. And then we just skip ahead to the register descriptions. The registers we are interested in is DDRD and port D. Now both of these registers, all the bits in them can be read and written to as indicated by the RW symbol here, and then we also have the initial value. So in the case of DDRD, all the pins will be set as input, and then in the case of port D, the initial value will be 0, so all of the pins will be driven low. Okay, now let's get to the coding of it. Okay, now we have the basic project here. Now, the first thing we want to do is, I forgot to add this in the project setup, but we want to hash include std int.h. Now this is just a standard library used to define data types, so you have better naming for your data type. Now the next thing we want to include is hash include util, and we want delay dot h. Now this is a library that's just used in general for delaying. Now the next thing is we want to right click, we say go to implementation, and then we just scroll down and we can say, see, here's the FCPU definition. Now that says if it's not defined, then define it as 10 million. We already have it defined in config.h as 16 million, so it won't define in the delay.h file. And then we have a function here, delay ms. This is the one we are going to use, so we're going to copy that. There's also another function in here, which is delay underscore us, which will delay in microseconds. So we go back to our C main. We add our delay ms. We say 1000 seconds, and we duplicate that line over, and we also say 1000 seconds. Now, back to blinking the LED, we want DDRD equals to 0x FF. So the entire D port as output, so it'll be in binary, it will be 0B12345678. So 8 ones in a row, so the entire B port as output. Now the next thing is want to blink the LED. So we say in our infinite loop, we say port D is equals to 0x80. So the top LED bit 7 on. So PD7 will be on the 80Mega328B, and that will be 0B1 and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 will be the equivalent binary number for that. Then we want to clear that LED so it is off for a bit. So we set that to 0. So we take here bit 7 is off. Then we build our solution, which is the symbol up here, or F7 is the shortcut. Okay, now our solution is built. Then we go to device programming. Now since I'm using a Pickett 4, I can't directly program, so I have to go via this interface. So we just click apply. I check if I can read the 80Mega328P. I can read it since I get device signature. We say memories, and then we just click program. Now, as you can see, the LED is actually blinking on the breadboard. Now, I have set bit 7 as a green LED. This is now actually more for the running LEDs. So you can see bit 1 will be over here, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then the 7th bit will be the green LED, and then it will restart from the beginning. Now, we want to make a running LED. So we add a variable to main. We say uint 16 underscore t, we call it run, and we say equals to 1 because we want it to start at the first LED. Then we just modify our code, so we initially want to clear port D, and then we want the port D equivalent to run. Then we just decrease our delay to 250 milliseconds, so it will take 500 milliseconds to turn an LED on and off. Then we say if run is greater or equals to 0x80, then we reset run to be equals to 1, else we want run to be multiplied by 2. So effectively what we are going to create here is we start run over here as 1, then we go over here. Every time we multiply by 2, we change the number to look like this in binary. Then we go like this, and then we just cascade down all the way down to there. And then we are going to hit the if over here, and then it resets back to 1. So the equivalent values will be 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, then 1. So this will create our running LED effect. And this is why we want to start a run at 1 and not at 0, because anything multiplied by 0 is 0. Now let's program the 80Mega328P again. We just go again here, we apply, memories, program. And as you can see, we can see the LED is moving one up and then resetting all the way back down here, and then again and again and again and again, and it will go and do this to infinitum. And that's a basic introduction to using the GPIO to blink LEDs and make a running LED on an 80Mega328P. A like, share, comment, and subscribe is always appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.